One child, one teacher, one pen, and one book can change the world. Respected elders and my dear brothers and sisters, today it is an honor for me to be speaking again after a long time. Being here with such a honorable people is a great moment in my life. I don't know where to begin my speech. I don't know what people would be expecting me to say. But first of all, thank you God for whom we all are equal, and thank you to every person who has prayed for my fast recovery and a new life. I cannot believe how much love people have shown me. I have received thousands of good wish cards and gifts from all over the world. Thank you to all of them. Thank you to the children whose innocent words encouraged me. Thank you to my elders whose prayers strengthened me. Dear brothers and sisters, do remember one thing. Malala Day is not my day. Today is the day of every woman, every boy and every girl who have raised their voice for their rights. There are hundreds of human rights activists and social workers who are not only speaking for human rights, but who are struggling to achieve their goals of education, peace and equality. Thousands of people have been killed by the terrorists and millions have been injured. I am just one of them. Dear sisters and brothers, we realize the importance of light when we see darkness. We realize the importance of our voice when we were silenced. In the same way, when we were in Swat, the north of Pakistan, we realized the importance of pens and books when we saw the guns. Dear brothers and sisters, do remember one thing. Malala Day is not my day. Today is the day of every woman, every boy and every girl who have raised their voice for their rights. There are hundreds of human rights activists and social workers who are not only speaking for human rights, but who are struggling to achieve their goals of education, peace and equality. Thousands of people have been killed by the terrorists and millions have been injured. I am just one of them. Dear sisters and brothers, we realize the importance of light when we see darkness. We realize the importance of our voice when we were silenced. In the same way, when we were in Swat, the north of Pakistan, we realized the importance of pens and books when we saw the guns. The wise saying, "The pen is mightier than the sword," was true. The extremists are afraid of books and pens. The power of education frightens them. They are afraid of women. The power of voice of women frightens them. Honorable Secretary General, peace is necessary for education. In many parts of the world, terrorism, wars and conflicts stop children from going to schools. We are really tired of these wars. Women and children are suffering in many parts of the world in many ways. Many innocent and poor children are victims of child labor. Young girls have to do domestic child labor and are forced to get married at an early age. Poverty, ignorance, injustice, racism, and deprivation of basic rights are the main problems faced by both men and women.